So Scoutadelic, the YouTube channel just for you. I'm Mike, and have we got a jam-packed show for you today? We've got this.
We call this a cato.
We've also got that. But first, I'm in Swansea for a reason, because I need a co-host. So who is my co-host going to be this month?
Ian!
Hi, I'm Gareth. I'm from Swansea in Wales. I'm the Chief Commissioner for Wales and also a beaver leader in Llangefelach, and this is my 60-second Scouter. My hero would be... Steve Jobs was quite a cool guy, because everyone told him he wouldn't do stuff, and then he managed to do it and went back to Apple. My favourite hobby at the moment is cycling. Ooh, three words to describe Scouting. Fun, adventurous, friends. The hardest word in Welsh I know would probably be most of them, because I don't speak a huge amount of Welsh, but I have trouble saying Llangefelach Gwynedd, which is a place name in North Wales. Bear Grylls or Bear, there's no doubt that the bear would win. The coolest thing about being a scout is actually getting to try different things and go different places. My favourite meal would have to be steak and chips. If my house was on fire, I would rescue my family first, then probably my laptop and coffee machine. If my life was a book, the title would probably be Oh No, Not Again. Free time. What's that?
So welcome to Scoutadelic. How are you?
Very, very good. A little bit nervous on trying to teach you this.
Oh, that's fine. So, what are you going to teach me and the rest of the million, billion people around the world that are scouts?
Every scout in Wales needs to know how to do it. And that's how to make Welsh cakes.
Welsh cakes?
Welsh cakes.
Okay. So.
Here are some we prepared earlier. They're very, very tasty. To do this, we have the ingredients and we need to get the pan. Now, I have to light the pan and get it going because we need it hot.
Right.
These are cakes which don't necessarily go in the oven. You cook them on a pan.
Right.
So they're really easy to cook on a campfire if you want to do. Technically, you should be, some people will say you've got to use a bake stone.
Right.
But I've got one. So the next thing we need, we have some butter.
Butter.
So these are measured out. Butter in the tub.
Right.
And then we need some flour. Now this is where you are going to be doing this part. I assume you've washed your hands.
I washed them beforehand.
What you need to do is rub these together with your hands and make it like breadcrumbs.
Right.
So all the flour and that, no lumps, but it needs to be like breadcrumbs. So hands in, rub until it comes like. This is a little bit messy, so we need to rub it all in. That's it. Mix. Right, it's not looking too bad now. Are you gonna start rubbing this with your hands?
Rubbing it like that.
That's it. Yeah. We'll get rid of all the lumps so it looks like breadcrumb.
So no lumps whatsoever?
No lumps.
Oh, right, okay.
So while we are making the breadcrumbs kind of stuff, the pan is here getting hot. And then you want this on a very, very low heat. And hot. The hotter the better. Add our...
Ta-da! Yeah,
that's close enough. Right, add the sugar.
Okay.
Right, the next thing we're going to add some key ingredients. Some mixed spices.
How much mixed spices?
Until it looks enough.
How do you know?
Smell. You don't have to. Some people don't put mixed spices in. I like to put a little bit in.
A little bit, yeah. As he takes off the full top.
Don't guess. This just adds a flavour, because sometimes some people like, I like to prefer Welsh cakes with a bit more cinnamony flavour.
Right.
Stir that up a little bit for me, just with it.
Okay.
You can use the spoon. Okay, right, and then we need the raisins. There's a secret ingredient that you could put into Welsh cakes. Not a secret ingredient, but sometimes people don't like raisins.
Right.
I have made them before with chocolate chips.
Ooh.
You've got to be careful when you do cook them because they can burn.
Chips.
But chocolate chips would be better. So that's it, stir it all up. We now need the egg.
Okay.
Take the egg.
Yep.
It's important that you put the egg in the mixture.
There we are.
However, you must crack the egg and not do as my instructions specifically say and put the egg in.
Crack the egg.
Yeah,
no shell.
No shell. Is there any shell? Is there shell?
No.
Use the wooden spoon and mix that in. What we want to do now is make this like a dough and make it into a paste. Now, I have I've got one egg in here. I also have a little bit of milk just to spare. That's doing very, very well, actually.
Right.
So just try and make it a big ball. So you make it a big ball, because we're going to be then rolling this out. Flour and a rolling pin.
Flour and a rolling pin.
Give up using spoon.
Okay.
And we're going to get this out and roll it out. But we're going to get some flour down first.
Yeah.
I did wipe this and clean it earlier with some kitchen roll. You could use chopping board, but this is actually fine.
Trust me.
So, make a big dough. Dot in the middle.
In the middle?
Right, no, don't. Yeah, kind of like that. Then you can get all these bits off here as well. You form it into a little ball. If you roll it around the flour a bit, it will just make a nice little dough, so you kind of knead it a little bit as well.
Right.
So just give it a little bit of shape, that's it. Now, if we make these too thick, if they make them actually really thick, ones are really nice. However, if we make them too thick, then they get a pain to try and turn in the pan.
Right.
So what we're going to do is we'll cut four out. We'll cook about four at a time.
Yep.
Flip them. So first of all, you can roll this out around about a centimetre thick.
A centimetre thick.
Yeah. So slowly, slowly, gently. What we may have to do. I can guarantee that somebody's going to be looking at this video going, they're not doing it right! We probably should have put a little bit of flour onto the roller. Don't roll it out too hard because you're making it stick.
Oh, right, sorry.
So,
I apologize.
Just a little bit at a time. You may have to stick a little bit more flour out in a sec. Here we go, try now. Do it a little bit, gentle bit, not too hard, that's it. And then we shall stop and we shall have another little turn of it. Good, right, you can get some shapes.
Yep.
So let's get the first few. So we'll have our stock of items here. So go on. So we'll get four ready. And then I'll get four. And then you need a bit of room in the pan to be able to turn them. What do you do to that?
What did you do to that? It looked fine. It looked fine until you went.
Over to the pan.
Yeah.
Put them in.
Yeah.
Key thing here is the pan needs to be very hot. Do not be tempted to turn the temperature up.
Right. Okay.
Patience is a virtue. So what we can do now is roll this out and we get the next ones ready. So we'll leave these ones cooking. So I just put these into the pan. Right, see them starting to move?
Yeah.
Right, that means it's time to move them.
Right,
so
okay.
So, pan underneath.
Yeah.
Turn them over.
Wow, okay.
Turn them over. Right, these are shaking.
Okay.
I'm going to take them off. They've turned out really well.
Ta-da! We are available for any Welsh parties, birthdays, celebrations. Oh, look at you, the hole that's moved.
Et voilà! These are some that
you made. Bellissimo!
Fantastico!
We want to see your results. So, send us a picture, whether Twitter or Facebook, and we may even get you a nice reward. So last month, Jags gave us his word of the month, which was?
Friendship.
And we had a fantastic response. So these are the five that we picked this month.
AHS Scouts showing their family and friends develop through scouting.
So this is Amelia making some friends on our last ever young leaders training. Well done.
So this is Anya, who is the most northern visitor at Scotshape, and she came and knew absolutely nobody there and left with loads of friends.
This is Rob making new friendship at a recent training session.
Here are the leaders of Giddesham Cubs who are friends at the Harlem Jamboree.
So those are the photos last month, but this month we need a new word. So Jags, take it away.
Is Jags with his word of the month?
Teamwork.
So, we need your teamwork photos in the next month, either via email, video clips, Twitter, Facebook, anywhere you like. Send us as many things as you can and let's get the best teamwork photos we can. So, now it's time for the night in the life of, and this is where we ask groups around the world to give us a little video of what they get up to in their weekly scouting. And this month we asked
First Clare Shannon in Ireland.
And this is what they did.
Yeah,
and we'll stop my genius.
Oh, the wrestling bug, the bug down in the valley, oh. Oh, the wrestling bug, the bug down in the valley, oh. And in their bug there was a hole, a rare hole, a wrestling hole. Holding the bug and the bug down in the valley, oh. Oh, the wrestling bug, the bug down in the valley, oh. Oh, the wrestling bug, the bug down in the valley, oh. In their hole there was a tree, a rare tree, a wrestling tree. Tree in the hole, and the bug down in the valley, oh. Bug, the bug down in the valley, oh. Oh, the rattling bug, the bug down in the valley, oh. And on the tree there was a branch, a rare branch, a rattling branch. Branch the tree, and a tree, and a hole, and hole in the bug, and the bug down in the valley, oh. Oh, the rattling bug, down in the valley, oh. Oh, the rattling bug, bug down in the valley, oh. And on the branch there was a twig, a rare twig. Taking the branch, the tree, and tree, and the hole, and the bug down in the valley, oh. Oh, the rattling bug, the bug down in the valley, oh. Oh, the rattling bug, the bug down in the valley, oh. And on the branch there was a leaf, a rare leaf, a rattling leaf. Leaf and the twig, and the twig, and the branch, and the tree, and the tree, and the hole, hole, and the bug down in the valley, oh. Oh, the rattling bug, bug down in the valley, oh. Oh, the rattling bug, the bug down in the valley, oh.
Okay, let's ask Greg. It's here to talk. So green a shot, and there is a new law in the town in August. Go.
One
neckerchief,
so this section's completely new. It started off as a debate between a scarf or neckerchief, and that made us think, what do people around the world call their scarf stroke neckerchief? Here they go.
Australia,
and here we call these
a scarf.
I am from Indonesia. We call this a kacu.
I'm from Thailand. We call this a papu ko.
I'm from Armenia, and this is the scarf.
In Uganda, we call it a katambala.
I'm from Hungary, and we call this a cherkisnyakendi.
I'm from Austria, and I call this a Halstuch.
So, ich bin der Christoph aus Deutschland und wir nennen das hier Halstuch.
I'm from East Lancs and we call it a necker.
I call these scarves.
Wales is called a necker.
Hi, I'm from Kent, Leith in Ireland and we call this a necker.
And we call it a neckerchief or a neckle.
I'm from Chile and I call this a bagnolin.
I'm from Michigan and we call this a necker.
Hi, I'm Marlissa from Canada and I call this a necker.
I'm from California and this is a neckerchief.
The New Zealand Eagle, this is a scarf.
We're from First Kings and Sea Scouts, Tasmania, Australia, and we call this a scarf.
So we always think at Scoutadelic that every scouter has a unique and interesting story to tell. And this month is no exception. This month we have Steve Judge telling us all about his scouting life.
Hi, I'm Steve Judge, and my scouting journey begins when I was 8 years old and I went to Cub Scouts in Hertfordshire. I moved up to Yorkshire when I was 9 and carried on with the fun, the challenge and the adventurous activities. I love joining in all the events. I feel that scouting gives you the opportunity to do that. And my first three badges, as you'll see from the photo, were swimming, cycling and running, which is very significant as I'll come to later on in my journey. After Cubs, I joined Scouts, and I loved doing the amazing activities, and I also really enjoyed gaining the badges. There were times when I'd take the badge book home, and I'd work out which badge I wanted next, and then I'd ask my mum or my dad or the Scout leader to help me to work towards those goals. After Scouting, in my young adult years, I moved on to Venture Scouts with the even more adventurous activities. And I remember working towards and gaining the ultimate by getting the Queen Scout Award. After that, I continued as a young leader for my local group. I eventually moved away from Scouting and did other things, including travelling around the world and starting a family. But in 2002, I had a near-fatal car accident. And due to me getting both my legs crushed, I was told that I may never walk again. It's at this time that I use my Scouting values to set myself goals and work towards them through my rehabilitation, eventually learning to stand again and walk again. And then I continue to set myself even more physical goals in swimming, in cycling, and eventually in running. And then as a disabled athlete, I entered myself into a power triathlon, swim, bike, and run, just like the first three badges that I got when I was in Cubs. And in my first year, I achieved as British champion in my category. Through my sporting career, I've received many accolades as British champion, European champion, and 2 times world champion. I've retired now from international competition and I run my own business as a personal life coach and also as an international keynote speaker, sharing my story with schools, businesses, and charities so as to help inspire and motivate others. I also work for the Scout Association in the media team, where my job is to help and support the development of media, to share and promote those values that Baden Powell instigated all those years ago, of fun, challenge, adventure, life skills, and opportunities. I get to work at amazing events like this with thousands of Cub Scouts having the time of their life at the Wildest Beach Party in Blackpool. And I also volunteer as a Cub Scout leader in Derbyshire, ensuring that the young people of today have the opportunities that I had when I was a child. And also, I can help them work towards their goals and achieve. And so that brings me full circle on my Scouting journey. And I'm still enjoying the fun, the challenge, and the adventure.
As you may or may not know, we at Scoutadelic have a mascot.
Hello!
And he has appeared in this episode.
This is my part of the show.
Sorry, Oggy.
You need to find me. Have you seen me?
If you find Oggy, let us know and you may win yourself a fantastic badge. So it's part of the show where we are challenged. But last month we had the newspaper balls challenge thanks to Bob the Beaver. So thank you very much. And we can announce that Phil from Broad Oak Explorers got 7 newspaper balls in 30 seconds. So well done to you. But this month, this is what we've got to do.
Hi, I'm Dariv, an explorer from Cardiff. This month, my challenge to you is, how fast can you say the Scout Law? But if you get any of the laws in the wrong order or make a mistake, then that's 10 seconds added to your overall time. Good luck.
Thank you again for your challenge this month. So, I have got a camera behind me to make sure that I don't cheat. I've got nothing in my hands and there is nobody either way of me. Here we go. A scout is to be trusted, a scout is loyal, a scout is friendly and considerate, a scout belongs to the world by a family of scouts, a scout is courage in all difficulties, a scout makes good use of his time and is careful of properties and possessions, and a scout has self-respect and respect for others. Ha ha ha, thank you.
I'm really nervous about this because I'm probably going to get them all wrong, but here we go. A scout is to be trusted, a scout is loyal, a scout is friendly and considerate, a scout is part of a worldwide family, a scout has respect for themselves and others, a scout looks after his possessions and makes good use of his time, and I've forgotten the last one. Terrible, there's one missing. No, lost it.
Okay.
I've lost it, yeah. What have I missed?
A scout, scouts to be trusted, a scout is loyal, a scout is friendly and considerate, you got them. A scout belongs to a wildlife family. Scout.
Yeah.
A scout has courage in all difficulties.
Courage, I forgot that. Yeah. See, this is the last bit, there I'm not getting courage in the difficulties. See, I'm staying here at campus thinking, what on earth is it? And it's the courage bit in a difficult situation.
What is it?
Being put on the spot.
Okay,
by right. You.
Fantastic, 2 months in a row, winner here. I want you to obviously knock him to the bottom of the list. So get your entries in on our website and let's see how many of you know your scout lore inside out without cheating on a mobile phone. So that's the end of our show. Don't forget to hit the subscribe and give this video a big thumbs up and be creative. Be part of our next show.
You can even be sitting here being the co-host and actually being the puppeteer for Oogie.
And by doing so, you may get yourself a Scoutadelic badge. But above all, be a little Scoutadelic. Bye.
Welcome to Scoutadelic.